Hello, welcome to Queen Code TV. Thank you for tuning in. Please, should in case you haven't subscribed, click the red button below that says subscribe and also click the bell beside it. This will notify you each time I drop a new video. Thank you. Please subscribe. Edakun, ejonto yolong, epe subscribe. Biko, gwala adwa nabi, ejonto yolong, e subscribe. OONI of Ile-ife, walata. Thank you so much.
You good, bros? Good.
Thank you, my friend.
Yeah.
Action.
Tape rolling. Action.
Brazil, we have a lot of universe, and being the wife of the king of Ile-ife, the cradle of Yoruba, the cradle of the Yoruba race, I have a role to play in working together with the king, my husband, because being a queen of that place, I am a mother to the Yoruba race. And so we are working towards bringing unity and bringing our people together in oneness and making sure that our heritage is kept alive so that we do not forget our ancestors who are our heroes past. So coming here, I've come to discover that our people are facing a lot of challenges. One is the racism, two is the gender issue, and also religious differences. So if we look at all these things, there are things that need to be attended to, and we have to do all that we can to see that our people have what have a right, have their right not taken from them. To see that they enjoy living the life that they should be. The black race is strong. Africa is a beautiful continent. And we have a lot of beautiful things that make us who we are, which is so much grounded in our culture. And so coming here, I've discovered that the people here are seen differently. Our people here, Yorubas, probably because of their skin, their belief as regards religion, and the woman, the black woman, and I represent very well the black woman. So the way the woman is seen as an object, and that also is stemming from the slavery mentality, where you think that the other person is not up to you, and then you begin to enslave. So it must stop from us, within us. That is where we can all stop it. And looking at these three things, I have said one thing, that we need to orientate our people, that it is all about love. For us to have a beautiful coexistence, for us to respect each other's color, each other's way of life, we need to preach the message of love. In fighting for our rights, I said it during my visit to the parliament, that in fighting for our rights, it is not so much about exchanging blows or words of hate, but preaching love, because because sometimes there is strength in love. Not sometimes, but most of the time, all the time. And you know, there's a lot of things that love can do to make things work between us. First is that if there is love, we are going to respect ourselves. We are going to respect what this person believes in. As Yorubas, we have what we believe in. Our ancestors believed in the gods that they served, and that is just their own way of reaching out to God. I said something about the elephant and the blind, like 10 blind men surrounding the elephant. All of them are going to see differently, feel differently. I think God is a spirit that we do not see, but we can feel. And so we feel differently. Let's just assume that everybody in the world is blind. And we all have a feeling. We all have a feeling of who God is. And so we worship Him in the way we think He is and what He looks like. So just because you feel God in this way, or that person feels it in that way, does not mean that you should disrespect that person or feel that person doesn't have a right to worship the way they think that they should. Religion that doesn't have love in it doesn't have God in it. Because the first thing is that religion is meant to be an instrument of unity, not an instrument of disunity. So I want all black race, all Yoruba race, all Africans to know that first of all, love is very, very important in all that we do, and we should respect who we are. Who we are determines how we serve God and how we choose to worship Him. It's our way of life. I'm an African woman. I'm dressed in the African way. I am in Brazil. It doesn't mean that just because I am like this, that the other person who is dressed differently from me is inferior to me. We all have our ways of life. This is my heritage, this is my culture, and that is the way, that is why I am like this. And also about the women, a man that has love in him will not treat his woman as an object. I want all African women to know that you are strong, and God has created you in a very unique way. He has given you authority that you give back, you reproduce. So there is power in your hands. You determine what comes out of you. One, if you are a loving mother, you will give back to a son who is going to love his wife, and one to treat his wife just the way you treat him. So we need to learn that. And we also need to know that the men who treat women less of who they are, because a woman is a womb woman. Is a womb woman. Sorry, I mean a womb man. That's what a woman is. A woman carries. A woman births. A woman is fertile. A woman is a field where you can grow seeds and wonderful seeds. I mean, so once the woman knows that, you look at that man who looks at you less of who you are, you know that this is a man who is wounded psychologically, who is ignorant, and ignorant, you know, is a disease. So your work as a woman is to heal this man, bring him up, and let him see how tall you are. So you need to bring them up to your level. So that's what I'm talking about. So I'm here to see how we can work together with our people here to see that they rise to it and show the younger generations who they are, and let them begin to act in that way. Let the change start from us. Let us show the others love and tell them that our culture is a beautiful one, that our culture is sweet, that our skin is unique and beautiful the way we have. Black actually is not devilish. Black is beautiful. Our culture is not demonic. It is beautiful from the way we dress, the food we eat, and the way we talk and walk. What is in us? We have love. We do not have hate. And when you look at the outlook of a black woman, you know there's a lot of beauty embedded in here that doesn't need any plastic surgery. So you need that God, you know that God has truly, truly blessed us. And when you look at a black man too, you see the king in him. You see that there's a lot of things that represent what God is. And God is universal. So let us not put God in a box and define him by one, by a retarded and local way of thinking. Let us not localize God. God is global. And the African, the black race, Africa, is global.
Thank
Shoki, we have a direct, just love it.